Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we'll be calculating the GDP deflator, but more importantly than that, we're going to learn how to use the GDP deflator to evaluate an increase or a decrease in the price level between two given years. With that said, let's get into it. So when calculating the GDP deflator, you'll need two key pieces of information, and that is the nominal and the real GDP for two different years. Now, if you don't know how to calculate the nominal or real GDP, don't worry, we have videos dedicated to each of those calculations on the channel, so feel free to check those out and then come back to this video after you know how to calculate them. In this example, we'll be given those values, but in an assignment question or perhaps on a test, you might be expected to calculate them and then plug in those values into the GDP deflator equation. Speaking of the formula or the equation for GDP deflator, it's simply nominal GDP divided by real GDP times 100. And so you might be looking at this saying, well, that's super easy. And to be honest, it kind of is. The interpreting of the GDP deflator is the tougher part. So let's begin by calculating the GDP deflator for the year 2020. So we're going to notice that we have the nominal and real GDP, and plugging them into the equation, we get 2,314 over 2,058 times 100. Continuing on with the algebra, we get a value of 1.124, and then of course multiplying that by 100, we get a value of 112.4. So that's the GDP deflator for 2020. Let's take note of this number, put it aside, and calculate the GDP deflator for 2021. As it's important to note that GDP deflator values are index numbers or they're ordinal numbers. And therefore, to actually compare them or to calculate the change in price level, you need multiple GDP deflator values. Upon subbing in the nominal and real GDP values for 2021, we get 2,601 divided by 2,135 times 100. Simplifying this further, we get 1.218, which of course times 100 is 121.8. And that number represents the GDP deflator for 2021. Calculating the GDP deflator seems easy enough, but the real question is, how do we use the GDP deflator to measure the change in price levels between these 2 years? So in our case, 2020 and 2021. Well, it's as simple as calculating the percentage change in the GDP deflator from 2020 to 2021. Now, I'm assuming that you know how to calculate percentage change, but if you don't, as I teach my students, it's simply new minus old over old. What I mean by that is the new GDP deflator, or the most recent one, is 121.8. That's the GDP deflator of 2021. I subtract the old GDP deflator, or the older year in this case is 2020, so I'm subtracting 112.4 and then dividing it by the old GDP deflator, which is 2020's GDP deflator of 112.4, and then multiplying that by 100%, because again, I want to know the increase or decrease in price level as a percentage. So simplifying this, I get a value of 0.084 as a decimal, but of course I want to turn that into a percentage, so I multiply by 100%, which gives me a value of 8.4%. But what does this 8.4% mean? How do I interpret this value that I've now calculated for? Well, it's actually the increase in the price level between 2020 and 2021. So upon calculating the GDP deflators for both years, we then calculate the percentage change from 1 year to the next, and that gives us the increase or decrease in the price level. So this is one way to calculate the increase or decrease in a price level, but you could also use something called the Consumer Price Index, or the CPI. Now, if you need a video outlining how to calculate that and what it's used for, then feel free to check out our video on the channel covering that topic, and we can also leave a link to it in the description. We hope that you found this video helpful, and if you did, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and of course, let us know in the comments section what type of economic videos you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.